السلام عليكم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It gives me great pleasure to stand here before you to remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your creator, your maintainer, your sustainer. My dear respected brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we have almost come to a conclusion of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the mercy that He allows us to see the next Ramadan insha'Allah. Bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well to accept this Ramadan from us. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I don't like asking the question, but I just want to ask, who knows what surah I was reciting right now? Surah Al-Baqarah. Who understood the verses I was reciting? Alhamdulillah, very good. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I want to go through the verses that I recited, the second page. So the last salat I was praying, the second page, I just want to go through the verses that I was reciting. And I want to highlight one thing. The main theme of this page is solely and purely to outline the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the main reason, that's the main subject or the main topic in this page. You have different agendas being addressed, but the one topic that it's aiming for, the one target, is the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's observe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He kicks off the page by saying, Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the wali. The wali means the one who takes care of their affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who takes care of the affairs of whom? The believers. Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. Yukhrijuhum min al-dhulumati ila al-nur. Now, a person that takes care of your affairs, now let's say you're taking care of me. Put yourself in that position. You're my carer. Your job is to do what? Is to take care of me, to take me out or to take me away from what harms me to something that is beneficial for me. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's saying Allah is the caretaker of those who say La ilaha illallah. They believe in Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves them from darkness and puts them into the light. The light of Iman, the light of taqwa, the light of having a peace of mind that if you're going to die tomorrow, you know what? I'm ready. If I'm going to die in the next second, I'm ready. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my caretaker. Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. طيب, what about those that don't want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be their caretaker? What's going to happen to those people? وَالَّذِينَ كَفْرُوا, and those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِينَ كَفْرُوا أَوْلِيَاؤُهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ. To them, you have other deities that are greater to them than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have other things that they think they're taking care of them. For example, even Muslims fall into this category. They fall into the category where they think there is something else other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that can be a caretaker. How? Whereby if I accumulate all the money and I save up my money and accumulate and accumulate and accumulate and no giving zakat, no giving sadaqah, no, not doing anything with my money, just saving it up, this will save me one day. Even Muslims fall into this, my dear respected brother. Don't think that, you know, it's just for the people that disbelieve in Allah, that say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not Allah. You know, I worship an idol, I worship, you know, something else. This is also for Muslims, the ones that say that my money will take care of me or my kids will take care of me. Think about this. For them, they will be removed from the light into the darkness because they have no one to take care of them. يُخْرِجُونَهُمْ مِنَ النُّورِ إِلَى الظُّلُمَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. So those who don't have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a caretaker, their destination will be in Jahannam. Why? Because they have no one to guide them and tell them to the straight path. And this is why the Qur'an is here. The Qur'an is here to take us to the right path, my dear respected brothers and sisters. طيب. Now let's get into the ayat that I want to get into. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the quality of being your caretaker. And only a person that's capable of being a caretaker, what are the qualities you look for? You look at someone that's capable of taking care of you, a person who is great. يعني me, I wouldn't hire you as a caretaker unless I know you're capable and you're a great person. You know, you've got power, you've got strength. So if I'm walking in the street and I've gotten someone that's not even strong and I said, you're going to be my caretaker, if someone's going to come and harass me on the street, what's my caretaker going to do? Is it worth having him as a caretaker? No. I'm going to get bashed. He's going to probably get bashed. So it's going to be chaotic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the quality of being your caretaker. If you're a believer, Allah is your caretaker. Like, what are the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah doesn't tell you His qualities, rather He shows you examples of His qualities. Whereby He says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ. There was a guy that these verses speak about, his name is Namrud. Namrud was this person. Who was Namrud? He was a person that ruled the earth. You see, there are four people who ruled the earth from east to west. Four people. Two of them were Muslim, two of them were kafir, were non-Muslim. You have from the Muslims, Sulaiman alayhi salam and Dhulqarnayn. You have from the non-Muslim, Namrud and Bukhtinasr. These were the four. Namrud was one of those four. Namrud was that person, he grew up without a mother and father. He grew up, he was raised in the jungles. And he was taught, some narrations say that he was taught by the jinn how to rule the world. And he ruled the whole world. He ruled the world from the east to the west. Everything. And he was in the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And after Ibrahim alayhi salam was perished from his lands, who heard of his story? The great king Namrud, the king of Babylon. Namrud. So what does this king do? He summons Ibrahim. He says, come over here. Tell me about your Lord. Because at the time, Namrud says, he was God. He was Allah. Namrud was saying that he was God. So the subjects around him, they were saying, look, Ibrahim is saying that there's a God other than you. So Namrud is saying, who is this God? Who is he? Bring Ibrahim to me. So he brings Ibrahim forward. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ. Do you see that man that said to Ibrahim, who is your Lord in front of me? These are the words. Look at the audacity. Who is your Lord in front of me? أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds you all. This man that's questioning Allah and saying, who is Allah in front of me? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ. That same person that's saying, who is Allah in front of me? Allah is the one who gave him his kingdom. Allah is the one who gave him his wealth. Allah is the one who gave him everything that he has today. Allah is the one who made him who he is. Who gave him the authority and the power on earth. Allah is reminding, أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ. Now Ibrahim is standing there. When he's asked, who is your Lord? What's he going to say? قَالَ رَبِّيَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ. Allah, my Lord, is the one who gives life and takes life. So Namrud laughs. Gives life and takes life. That's easy. So he gets two groups. Prisoners, two groups. He orders the execution of one group and says to the other group, you're free to go. And he says, I have given death, I've taken life, and I've given life. I've killed a group, and I have freed a group. Fair, khalas. Namrud is the type of person, there's a proverb that says, عَقْلُ صغير. His brain is very small. In his capacity, his brain capacity is quite small. So he thought, what Ibrahim alayhi salam meant, is that he kills a person and he lets a person go. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gives life, he creates it from scratch. From the very beginning, he molds you and shapes you. And then he does something that absolutely science, no matter how advanced it becomes, medicine, no matter how advanced it becomes, it will never have the capabilities of granting the soul. The ruh. You see, when we die, the ruh gets released and the body is nothing. It decays. So all right, Ibrahim says, fair game, no worries. So now look at Ibrahim. What does he say to him? He says, okay, if you can give life and take life, then I assume that you can control the earth. My Lord will rise the sun from the east, set it in the west. So Allah, my Allah, He'll rise the sun from the east, and then your job is just bring it down from the west. Does that seem too hard? No. Just grab it down. That's it. قال إن قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأتي بها من المغرب. So what was the response of Namrud? فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرْ. How am I going to do that? If the sun is in my eye, I can't even look at it, let alone grab it and then put it in the west. فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرْ. He was quiet. والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not guide a person who is a tyrant, a person who is an oppressor. And just to tell you the ending of this Namrud, the one that went up against Allah, it got to him so much that Allah was greater than him and Allah was his Lord. What do you think this person done? This person went to an open ground. Look at the audacity of this man. He went to an open ground with his whole army. He assembled his whole army from beginning to end. This is a man who ruled the earth. And what did he do? He stood in front of the grounds and he raised his sword and he said, "Come on, Ya Allah, bring it on. I want to take you to war. Bring all your armies. Let's see. This is the finale. This is the one that determines." Wallahi, I got goosebumps just talking about it. He says, "I want to take on Allah. Let Allah bring all his army down. Let him bring everything that he has to take me on. And then we'll see who's the greatest." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a group of mosquitoes down to fight. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent something on the same caliber as his army. So he just sent down, some narrations say it was a swarm of mosquitoes, and some narrations say it was a swarm of flies. So what happened? The army was ambushed by the mosquitoes. And they're sitting down, the whole troop is going crazy, trying to get away. You know how when you see a mosquito and it comes near you, just near your ears, straight away, you're trying to flick it away. Now Namrud began to run. He was caught off guard. What's going on? As he's running, he tripped. And as he tripped, he breathed in and a mosquito went right up into his nostril. And your nostrils lead into your brain. Now this mosquito, and subhanAllah, just to show you something in science, the Qudra of Allah. In scientifically speaking, the hairs that you have on your nose and the mucus that you have in your nose prevents anything foreign from entering and going up into the brain. But subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disabled it in the case of Namrud and it went straight up. The Qudra of Allah. But Allah didn't want to finish him then and there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to prolong his torture, wanted to prolong his humiliation. So this man, every time the mosquito would go psycho, just wants to leave, it would start going crazy in his head, and it would make him become crazy. The only way that he would seek comfort was by hitting himself in the head. This is a king, the one who ruled from the east to the west, the whole earth, hitting himself on the head. It got to the point he couldn't bear it, so he ordered his guards with a massive bat to whack him on the head every time the mosquito started to move, so he can calm down. So one day the guard said, you know, every day this is happening. This is his whole routine. He's standing next to Namrud. Namrud goes crazy. Whoop, cracks him on the head one. And Namrud calms down. This is a ruler of the earth. Until one day the guard next to him said, you know what, maybe if I give him one good crack, I'll kill the mosquito inside. Namrud went crazy. Boom! Split his head right open, killed him then and there. This is the king of the earth. The ruler of the earth wanted to take the ruler of the universe, the creator of the universe. And look at his ending. He died by his own guard smacking on the head because he wanted to. SubhanAllah, this is the azama of Allah. I don't have enough time to go into the next verses, but look at the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers, the take-home message is tadabbur in the Qur'an. Have contemplation in the Qur'an. When you recite the Qur'an, look at the stories that you're reading. Look at the reasons why they were revealed and really live with the Qur'an. Because that's the purpose of the Qur'an, my dear respected brothers. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear sisters, forgive me. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and to accept from us. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Qur'an, you know, in our hearts. For us to contemplate the Qur'an, inshaAllah. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallah wa hamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaykum. Wa ala salatikum. Athabakum Allah.
We are one Ummah who should stand with each other through all the highs and lows.